Hey everyone, welcome to SFDC Stop, and in this video we are going to solve a particular use case, which is sorting a list of S object records based on a field value. Okay, and if you remember, in the previous video we learned about enums and we also learned about custom comparator. So I'm going to use these two concepts to solve this particular problem. What we have done here, we have created a list of accounts, and each account is having a name, it is having a number of employees, and it is having an annual revenue as well. So I queried my initial list of accounts, and you can see the list here. So you can see that I'm having Huli with number of employees as 50 and annual revenue as 10,000. I'm having Pied Piper as well, and I'm having Avyato as well. So all the accounts that I inserted above are visible. Okay. Now let's say I want to sort this list of accounts by number of employees in ascending order. So I can do that as well. I can sort these list of accounts by name field in ascending order. I can do that as well. I can sort these list of accounts by annual revenue field in ascending order. So I can do that as well. Okay. Similarly, I can sort these list of accounts by different fields like number of employees, name, or annual revenue in descending order as well. So I'm just going to execute this code once, and then we'll see how we have implemented this method. Okay. So if you see, this is our initial list of accounts. This is the account sorted by number of employees in ascending order. So you can see that first of all, I'm having Avyato, which is number of employees as 10. Then I'm having Pied Piper with number of employees as 20. And then I'm having Huli with number of employees as 50. After that, I have account sorted by name in ascending order. So first of all, I'm having Avyato. Then I'm having Huli. And then I'm having Pied Piper. Correct. After that, I'm having account sorted by annual revenue in ascending order. So first of all, I'm having Pied Piper with the least annual revenue, then I'm having Huli with annual revenue as 10,000, and then I'm having Avyato with annual revenue as 15,000. Similarly, I'm having these in descending order. For example, if I talk about number of employees in descending order, so first of all, I'm having an account with 50, and then I'm having an account with 20 employees, and then I'm having an account with 10 employees, correct? And after that, I'm having these accounts sorted by name in descending order. So first of all, I'm having Pied Piper, then Huli, and then Avyato. Similarly, I can also have this account sorted by annual revenue in descending order. So first of all, I'm having Avyato with the maximum annual revenue. Then I'm having Huli with 10,000 as annual revenue. And then I'm having Pied Piper with 5,000 as annual revenue. So now let's see how I have used the concepts of enum and the concepts of custom comparator to solve this particular problem. So what I have done, I have created a class named as sortUtil, which is my utility class for sorting. And in that class, I have created a method named as sortRecords, where I'm passing my list of S objects, which is the list of accounts. I'm passing on which order I want to sort in, whether ascending or descending. And I'm also passing in the field name using which I want to sort my accounts. And after that, I'm also passing in what is the type of this particular field. Is it an integer? Is it a string? Or is it a decimal? Okay, so I'm taking three types here. You can extend it as per your requirement. But I'm going to show you how I have implemented this class. And at the end of the video, I'll give you the code as well, so that you can use it in your own projects. Now let's have a look at the sortUtil class and let's see how we have implemented this. So inside this class, we are having four properties. First of all, one is the record, which is nothing but the original S object record. Second is the sortUtil value. And this value is nothing but a enum that I have defined over here. It can have ascending or descending as a valid value. Next is the field name. So field name basically specifies which field I want to use to sort my records. Okay, so it is of type string. The next one is value type. So value type is what is the type of the value in my field, whether I'm having a string value in my field or an integer value in my field or a decimal value in my field. So this value type is basically an instance of type enum. So that is why I'm having three valid values for this particular type. Now let's see what we have in the constructor. So in the constructor of this sortUtil class, I'm first of all accepting a single record. I'm accepting the sortUtil value, I'm accepting the field name, and I'm accepting the value type. So all these four properties I'm accepting in my constructor as well. Okay. Now let's move on to our sortRecords method, because if you remember, this is the method that we're calling from our sortUtil class. So whenever I'm sorting a list of accounts, I'm going to call the sortRecords method from my sortUtil class. I'm going to pass in a list of accounts, and I'm going to pass in whether I want to sort these accounts as ascending or descending, the name of the field, and also the type of the field value. Okay. So if I see here, this sortRecords method is first of all accepting the list of S object records, the sortUtil value, which is of type sortUtil, which can be ascending or descending. Okay. And the name of the field that I want to use to sort these records, and the type of the value. So the type of the value can be type string, type integer, and type decimal. For example, if I talk about this particular account record, so I can say that I want to sort my account records in ascending order and based on the number of employees field, and this field is of type integer. I want to sort my account records in descending order based on the name field, and this field is of type string. Okay, so this is what I am passing in my sort records method. Now, what we have done inside this method, first of all, I'm converting my records list into sort utils list. So for each and every record, I'm creating a new instance of my sort utils class, and I'm adding this instance to sort utils list. Okay, so I'm preparing a list of sort utils class, which is my custom, I can say, user defined class, by passing in each record one by one, because if you remember, here I can only accept one record. So each instance of sort utils class is basically going to consist of one single record. Finally, I'm calling sort method on my sort utils class, which is automatically going to sort all the records based on my field name and the value of this field. And once these records are sorted, I'm going to clear my original record list, and then I'm going to re-prepare my original record list by using the sort utils list. Because if you remember, this list is sorted now, so I'm going to iterate over this sorted list, and I'm going to create my record list again by using the records in the, or I can say by adding the records in the sorted order. I'm passing a reference to the original records list inside this method as a parameter, which is the default behavior of Apex. And then I'm clearing the original records list, and I'm updating the original records list. So that is why I don't need to return anything. Okay, because I'm basically operating on the original records list. Now let's see how this sort method is able to sort my list of records. In order to implement the sort method, or I can say in order to use the sort method in my custom class, if you remember from the previous tutorials, we have to implement comparable interface, right? And this comparable interface is having a compare to method, which is going to compare two records of this type, and it is going to return me how I want to sort these records, correct? So what I'm first of all having the original record, which is nothing but this one itself, the sortUtils class, and I'm having another record, which is another instance of the sortUtils class. But in this case, I'm not comparing these two records based on the sortUtils class. I'm comparing these two records based on the original records value. So what I'm doing, I'm first of all getting the original record from my sortUtils class. Okay, so this is my sortUtils class, and this is the original record. I'm getting it from here. And once I have the S object record, then I'm first of all checking whether I'm going to compare string type or integer type or decimal type values. In case I'm going to compare string type values, I'm going to get the original field value from the original record as well, and I'm going to get the original field value from the another record as well. And then I'm going to typecast these values into strings, because these values are of type strings, and I'm going to compare these two strings and return the result. So just to specify once again, this is the original record, which is coming from here. This is another record, which is nothing but second record that I'm comparing with the original record from the another instance of sortUtils class. Okay. Once I have both the records, I'm getting the same field values by using the field name from my original record as well, and from my second record as well. And then I'm converting these values into string, because these values are of type string. Okay. Because this get method is basically going to return new object, so I have to typecast it into a string. So I'm converting it into a string, and then I'm comparing two strings to return the result. Similarly, in case my field values are integers, I'm comparing two integers to return the result. Similarly, if my field values are decimal, I'm comparing two decimals to return the result. If you remember, in this case, let's say if I want to compare the accounts by name, then all the account names are going to be string, right? In case I want to compare the accounts by annual revenue, then all the accounts annual revenue are going to be decimal type, correct? So if the type is string, I'm converting it into a string. If the type is integer, I'm converting it into, or typecasting them into integer. If the type is decimal, I'm typecasting them into decimal. So I have different helper method to return me the correct value, because if you remember from the compare to method, I can only return either a minus one, either a zero, or a plus one, depending upon whether I want to keep the current record previous to the second record, or next to the second record, or these are equal. So the compare string method is going to compare these two string values that I'm getting from the fields. So this is the source value, and this is the destination value. And then I'm checking, first of all, whether I want to sort my records in ascending order or descending order. In case I want to sort these records in ascending order, I'm checking if the source value is less than the destination value, I'm going to return minus one. Okay. This simply means that I want to keep the source record before the destination record. Okay. In case the source value is equal to the destination value, I'm going to return zero. Otherwise, I'm going to return one. We have already discussed this concept in our custom comparator tutorial. So in case it is not clear to you, you can refer to that tutorial. Similarly, I'm checking for descending as well. So in case of descending, either I can replace these signs or I can replace the values. So in this case, I'm replacing the values. So in case of lesser, I'm having 1 here. In case of equal, it is going to be the same. And in case of greater, I'm going to have minus 1 here, right? Similarly, I'm having another method named as compare integers, which is going to compare two integers. So this is having the integer value 1, integer value 2. And in case of ascending order, if the source value is less than destination value, I'm going to return minus 1. In case the values are equal, I'm going to return 0. Otherwise, I'm going to return 1. Similarly, in case of descending order, if the value is less than destination value, I'm going to return 1. If equal, I'm going to return 0. Otherwise, I'm going to return minus 1. Similarly, I have compared decimals as well, that in case I'm sorting in ascending order, and if the source value is less than destination value, return minus 1. If equal, return 0. And otherwise, return 1. And in case source value is less than destination value, and I'm sorting in descending order, so in that case, I'll replace the signs. I'll return 1 here, I'll return 0 here, and I'll return minus 1 here. So these minus 1, 0, and 1 values are actually returned from my compare to method, and it is going to arrange these two instances of the sort total type based on the values that I'm returning. So basically, first of all, I'm getting the records from my sort total class to get two records. So first record is this one, another record is this one. Then I'm getting the field values from my original record and another record. And then I'm using these two values to make a comparison between these two records, and I'm going to arrange my sort total records accordingly. Okay, so at the end, it is going to sort a list of my sort total class, but for making the comparison, it is going to take out record first of all, and then it is taking the values from these two records. Based on these two values, it is going to make a comparison, and it is going to return me minus 1, 1 or 0, depending upon whether I'm sorting in ascending or descending order. So once we have this list of sort total sorted in ascending or descending order based on the values, I'm simply going to refill this records list based on the value of the sort total records. Okay, so that is how we are having the list of accounts in sorted order depending upon a particular field value. So let me just execute this code once again to show you the result. So if you see, this is our original list, which is the initial list of accounts. And then I'm sorting the accounts list according to the number of employees in ascending order. So I'm having values as 10, 20, 50. Then I'm sorting accounts list according to the name in ascending order. So first of all, I'm having Aviato, then Huli, and then Pied Piper. And in each case, I'm first of all passing whether I want to sort this list in ascending or descending order. I'm passing the field name, and I'm passing the type of the field as well, so that in case I'm getting the annual revenue field value, I know that I want to typecast it into decimal type. Because using this type underscore decimal, I am able to identify how I want to typecast these fields. Okay, so in case it's annual revenue, I'm passing in type underscore decimal, and it is typecasting it into decimal fields. So that is how the sort total class is working, and that is how you can sort any kind of S object record based on the field name in ascending or descending order, and by passing in the type of the value. So in case you are having more data types as well, you can just add an entry here for different data type. You can add a condition here for that data type, and you can add your own helper function. So I'm going to give you all the code that we have discussed in this particular video in the description. And I'll see you next time. I hope this thing is clear to you, and let me know your feedback in the comments down below. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Till then, have a good day. Bye-bye.